If you've ever been told your chronic symptoms are just stress or hormones, or that your labs look fine even though you feel terrible, you need to hear this. Your inflammation isn't coming from one single trigger. It's not one food. It's not one bad gene. It's not even one diagnosis. What you're experiencing is what I call the perfect storm. And today I'm going to show you exactly how the storm brews, why it keeps you stuck in that cycle of fatigue, brain fog, and body aches, and most importantly, how to start calming it. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Kara Wada, a board-certified allergy, immunology, lifestyle medicine physician, and I've dedicated over 15 years of my life helping people with complex immune conditions, and I live with one called Sjogren's disease myself. I deeply understand the journey of living with a body that often feels like a complex puzzle that we can't find the right orientation of the pieces. And this is the first episode in a 5-part series that will change how you understand your body and give you the roadmap to finally start healing. Let me begin by painting you a picture. You're a high-achieving woman. You've built a career. You've raised kids. Maybe you're caring for your aging parents. You have done everything right. But somewhere along the way, your body started sending distress signals. Maybe it started with exhaustion that coffee couldn't fix. Then came the digestive issues like bloating, constipation, chronic diarrhea, or just feeling off. Your joints started aching or feeling stiff. Your eyes, mouth became painfully dry, irritated. Dental checkups have not been great. And then brain fog rolled in like a thick cloud, making it harder to focus at work or to really connect with your spouse or your kids. You went to the doctor, you got your labs done, and you were told everything looks normal. It's probably just stress, you're not getting enough sleep, or maybe it's perimenopause, but you know deep down that something else is going on. And here's what I want you to understand. You're not wrong. And you're not broken. What's happening in your body is complex, yes, but it's also completely understandable once you start seeing the pattern and you know the pattern to look for. Most people, and honestly, most doctors, approach chronic inflammation like they're looking for one smoking gun. It's that root cause that everyone's talking about, right? Food sensitivity, maybe it's a gluten or a dairy issue. Chronic Lyme or another infection like EBV or one genetic mutation like that MTHFR. But that's not how chronic inflammation works. Chronic inflammation is like a weather system. It's not one cloud. It's the convergence of multiple forces that are all feeding each other, creating what meteorologists would call a perfect storm. So what are these four forces that I'm talking about, that are all coming together? I want to introduce you to the four biological disruptors that create the perfect storm of chronic inflammation. I want to initially start with the breached levee, the barrier breakdown. I want you to think of the lining of your gut, your skin, your airway, like your sinuses, your throat, down into your lungs, even your genital urinary tract. They're designed to keep your inner world calm and the outer world primarily out. But when these barriers get damaged, whether it be from stress, from infections, ultra-processed foods, chronic inflammation itself, they become more permeable. This is where the term leaky comes into play. So when your gut barrier is breached, bacterial products, undigested food particles can slip through into spaces where then your immune system, your nervous system can recognize them. This increases the potential that your immune system can see these invaders and sound the alarm. And that is one place where systemic inflammation can begin. The same thing happens in your sinuses when chronic inflammation allows bacterial toxins to penetrate, or irritants, air pollution, dust mite allergen, pet allergen, increased pollen counts, or on your skin with conditions like eczema when you use the nice fragrance like Bath & Body Works lotions, right? This barrier breakdown often is the first domino to fall, but it's not happening on its own. All of these, forces we're talking about are like a tight intertwined ball of yarn, and we're trying to pull out different pieces of the yarn, and we have to pull them out gently to finally untangle the mess that's there. All right, so we're going to talk about now the shifting winds. This is microbial imbalance. Your microbiome are those trillions of bacteria, viruses, fungi, other living beings that are on our skin, in our respiratory tract, in our gut. And it acts like the jet stream in our weather metaphor. When it's balanced, it keeps everything flowing smoothly. But when that balance shifts, what we call dysbiosis, everything downstream changes. So here's the science. Good bacteria, beneficial bacteria, produce compounds called short-chain fatty acids, or SCFAs. These are like the calm air that tell your immune system to stand down. They're essential for developing regulatory T cells, the peacemakers, your immune system that prevent autoimmunity and allergy. But things like antibiotics, chronic stress, low fiber diet, all these things can disrupt this ecosystem. The short chain fatty acid production plummets, and your immune response then skews towards inflammation instead of tolerance. And here's the kicker. The dysbiosis can actually damage your gut barrier even more. So this is a bit of a snowball effect where the wind will feed the flood. All right, now we're going to get to the thunder and lightning. Our immune system and our nervous system in chaos. You know, once inflammation is kicked off, your immune system and nervous system get locked in this vicious feedback loop. Chronic stress puts your immune system on high alert, overactive fight or flight, low vagal tone. You'll hear it discussed all different ways. That sympathetic overdrive pushes your immune system towards more inflammation. And at the same time, your dysregulated immune system releases inflammatory cytokines that can cross the blood-brain barrier, causing neuroinflammation. That neuroinflammation keeps your nervous system on edge, which keeps your immune system firing. You're stuck. Thunder feeds lightning, lightning feeds thunder. I know that's not how it actually happens up in the sky, but bear with me. But this is where brain fog, insomnia, tired but wired, and even where we think some of the increased rates of anxiety, depression, and other mental health diagnoses go along with inflammatory conditions. And the worse, for instance, your allergies are, we know the increased likelihood that you also suffer from anxiety or depression. All of this is exhausting. So now we're going to talk about the stalled pressure system. It's metabolic dysfunction. All of this, the barrier damage, the dysbiosis, the neuroimmune chaos, it demands massive amounts of energy from your cells. But eventually, your cellular engines, your mitochondria, they can't keep up. And we think in some cases, their dysfunction may drive this process from the get-go too, but they become sluggish, they're dysfunctional. And instead of producing clean, efficient energy, they switch to a less efficient fuel source. And worse, these struggling mitochondria start producing inflammatory exhaust, reactive oxygen species that act as new danger signals, telling your immune system to keep on attacking. So now you're in this vicious feedback loop where your cells can't make energy, and the act of trying creates more inflammation. The storm is stalled overhead, and you're left with crushing fatigue, crashes after meals, and feelings like there's no recovery in sight. Does any of this sound familiar? So here's what makes the perfect storm so insidious. These four forces don't exist side by side. They actively feed each other. Barrier breakdown allows for bacterial translocation, which worsens dysbiosis. Dysbiosis produces less of those protective short-chain fatty acids, which damages barriers even more. The immune chaos demands energy, which exhausts your mitochondria. Your struggling mitochondria produce inflammatory signals, which amp up the immune response, and chronic stress from your nervous system impacts every single one of these systems. This is why chasing one root cause doesn't work. It's why eliminating one food or taking one supplement often feels like it's putting a Band-Aid on a hurricane. You can't fix a storm by chasing one raindrop. You need to understand the entire weather pattern, and then, this is key, you need a systematic approach to help calm each of these forces while working to restore balance to the whole system. So how do we do that? How do we calm the perfect storm? This is where the Immune Competent Institute for our framework comes in. And this is the roadmap I use with every single one of my patients. And it's what the rest of the series will unpack. First, we're going to recognize, we identify where your levees are leaking, which systems are most dysregulated, and what your unique storm pattern looks like. This isn't guesswork. It's precision work through targeted labs, detailed history, and pattern recognition. Number two, we reclaim. We rebuild your foundation. That means restoring barrier integrity, rebalancing your microbiome. We're not just patching the levee. We're changing the weather pattern itself. Number three, rebel. We actively interrupt these old feedback loops. This is where your nervous system regulation and immune recalibration come into play. We teach your body a new pattern, one that doesn't default to inflammation and overdrive. And fourth, we rise. Finally, we restore cellular energy systems. We get your mitochondria functioning again and rebuild metabolic flexibility and true vitality. This isn't a quick fix, but it's a real fix. And if you're watching this and you're thinking, that's me, that's exactly what I've been experiencing, I want you to know there's a reason you feel this way. You're not making it up. You're not broken. And there is a path forward. Over the next four episodes, we are going to track each of these weather systems in detail. In episode two, we'll explore the breached levee, how barrier breakdown happens, why it matters so much, and the first steps to sealing those leaks. Episode three, we're going to talk about the shifting winds, the microbiome. You'll learn exactly how dysbiosis drives inflammation and what it takes to rebuild microbial balance. Number four is where things get intense, the thunder and lightning. We'll dive into that neuroimmune feedback loop and why regulating your nervous system is a non-negotiable for immune system health. And last but not least, in episode five, we'll tackle that stalled pressure system, the metabolic and mitochondrial dysfunction, how to restart your cellular engines so you can finally have sustainable energy again. Each episode will give you both science and the practical steps. Because I don't want you to just understand what's happening. I want you to feel empowered to do something about it. Before you go, I want to ask you a question, and I really want you to think about it. Which of these four forces feels most familiar in your story? Is it the gut issues, food sensitivities, the exhaustion and brain fog, the stress and sleep problems, or is it that crushing, unrefreshing sleep, that fatigue that just won't lift? I want you to drop a comment below to let me know. I read every single one, and your answer will help me tailor the rest of the series to what you need most. And if you want to go deeper right now, I've created a free resource for you, the Immune Confidence Storm Tracker, your 4R roadmap to recognizing your inflammation triggers and calming the storm. It's a self-assessment tool that takes about 10 minutes and will help you identify which of these four forces is most active in your unique storm pattern. You get clarity on where to start your healing. The description is in the link below. Go to download it now while it's fresh in your mind. And please hit the subscribe button. Over the next few weeks, we're going to be on a journey together from chaos to clarity, from storm to calm. You've weathered the perfect storm of 2025. The symptoms, the setbacks, the invisible battles that come with chronic illness. If you're watching this series, you're someone who's ready to understand what's been happening in your body. And more importantly, you're ready to move on. So here's my question. What if 2026 could look and feel different? Not just better managed or less bad, but truly different, expanded, bold. I'm hosting a special live workshop on Thursday, December 4th called Reclaim, Rebel, and Rise, a bold vision for 2026. This isn't a sales event. This is an immersive experience where we'll walk through the Immune Confident 4R framework together, not just as concepts, but as a lived practice. Here's what we'll do. Recognize. We'll reflect on the year that has been 2025 and release what is no longer serving us. The patterns, the beliefs, the weight that we've been carrying that we just don't need to carry into this new year. Reclaim. I'll guide you through a powerful visioning exercise to reclaim your energy, your agency, and your voice. This is where you'll start to see what's possible. Rebel. You'll identify one small, bold action that will move you closer to that vision. Not overwhelming, just one courageous next best step. And rise, we'll integrate and celebrate to anchor the sense of forward movement. You'll leave with a personalized vision map, a tangible document anchored in the Immune Confident framework that you can reference throughout 2026. This workshop is free for all of our Immune Confident Institute members. If you're not a member yet, it is just $26, and that cost can be applied to any future purchases in our practice. The link to register is in the description below. Spots are limited because I want this to be an intimate and meaningful experience. If you've been searching for a community that gets it, that understands the complexity of what you're going through and still holds space for what is possible, this is your moment. I'll see you December 4th. Now, go download that storm tracker and let's start mapping your path forward.